Nate.
Now I'm coming to you in a different role. But it's my great pleasure to introduce one of my house colleagues who I introduced a little bit earlier, Mary Franzen. Mary is one of our sophomore members, so that means she survived last year's tsunami. And Mary is somebody who comes to us in a very unique position. She's an in-home daycare provider. And if any of you followed the last couple of years down here at the Capitol, Governor Dayton and the Liberals have been trying to unionize our private business owners. Kim and I sent Reagan and Will to an in-home daycare center, great mother and daughter team, Miss Steph and Miss Kaylee. They called me when Governor Dayton tried to do this and said, how do we tax ourselves? We own the business. Well, there was somebody fighting out on the front lines for you. She's a mom, she's a rock rib conservative, she's one of our bright and shining stars in the Republican caucus. Please help me in welcoming Representative Mary Franzen.
God sure has a great sense of humor, doesn't he? But thank you. Thank you to all you patriots for being here today, and I'm thrilled to be with you. And I wish I had good news. Unfortunately, I'm here to tell you what we have already seen. The American dream is under attack. Big government is its name. And if you've been paying attention to what's happening at the legislature the recent weeks, you've seen it and you know it. It's higher taxes for all hardworking Minnesotans. Higher taxes on your income. Higher taxes on your beer and wine. Higher taxes on your clothes, and even higher taxes on your Minnesota Twins jerseys. I like to say WOW. WOW stands for War on Workers, War on Women, War on Wallets, basically war on whatever the DFL wants to declare war on. WOW. Do you remember when President Bill Clinton said, the era of big government is over? Lately, it seems like the mantra of Governor Dayton and the Democrats in the legislature is, the era of big government is overdue. Boo. And you know what lurks right behind big government? It's big unions. And do you know what they want to do? They want to unionize hard-working child care providers of Minnesota, whom most are women, by the way. Our child care workers aren't big government workers. They are private business owners who deserve to be independent and who do not need to be taken over by the likes of AFSCME. And as you probably can tell, this issue is near and dear to my heart, because before I ran for office, I was a child care provider. I owned my own small business. As someone who grew up without a mom and without a lot of money, it was my American dream to be able to do that, to own my own business. Now big unions see an opportunity to line their pockets off the success of our American dream, off the hard-working business owners like you and me, by making child care providers pay union dues. Is that what Democrats mean by making people pay their fair share? This is an effort that's been going on for over 7 years, the attempt to unionize thousands of small business owners. And in the last 7 years, there's over 11,000 professional child care providers out there. Out of 7 years, only 57 members have decided to join AFSCME. 57 out of 11,000 providers. I would say that's a failed pilot program and move on. Yeah. Unionization will lead to fewer choices, lower quality of care for those who need it the most. In fact, why are the unions lying to the public? If they're really after public subsidy money, then the government should just write them out a check for $4 million and leave the providers out of it. But no, they want to put the child care workers under attack. Well, I'm going to continue to fight this unionization effort at the legislature, but I'm only one voice in the minority. fight. Together, we can say it's morning in Minnesota or the American dream. That's the next Minnesota miracle.